Hello students, our today's topic is spare time or balance time. Now we can have three types of spare time graphs for moving body. There are three cases. Now first case is there when the speed of the body remains constant. When the speed of the body remains constant, there is no acceleration or there is no acceleration. So when the speed of the body changes at uniform rate, there is uniform acceleration. Now when the speed of the body changes in non-uniform way, there is non-uniform acceleration. These are three cases is there. Now first point, speed time graph when the speed remains constant. Now if the speed time graph, of a body is a straight line parallel to the time axis, then the speed of the body is constant or uniform. Now we know that speed is equal to distance traveled upon time taken. So distance traveled, we can also write here, suppose that distance traveled is equal to speed into time, This is our first equation. Now speed at C point, speed at C is equal to CB. CB is equal to OA. Thus, speed at C OA. Why? Because CB is equal to OA. So C is equal to OA. This is our second equation. Now, time at C on x-axis. Time at C is equal to OC. Now this is our equation, speed at C is, it means that CB and CB is equal to OA, and it means that C is equal to OA. This is our second equation, and time at C on x axis, C is equal to OC. Now putting this value of the speed and time in relation, first we get distance traveled, speed, and speed CB is equal to OA, it means that OC. Speed at C is equal to OA, it means that OA is here. Now time taken, time at C is equal to OC, so OC is here. Or also you can write here, distance traveled is equal to area of rectangle OABC. Correct? OABC. Thus, in a speed time graph, the area enclosed by the speed time curve and the time axis gives us the distance traveled by the body. So the velocity, time graph of an object moving with constant velocity or uniform velocity is a straight line parallel to the time axis. This is our speed time graph when the speed remains constant.